I got a name for your judge. Cornelius Holden. He just made a call to Lou.
I get worked up. I barely avoided that lunatic, Lou. Then I pay me enough to stop you right there, Cornelius. Never know who might be listening in. You need to get this shit under control here. Because until you do, your brother's case isn't going anywhere. There's no call for that kind of talk. I'll send over a car, a couple of my best men.
Cornelius is 60. The dipshits of this state first elected him to the Fifth Circuit in 1951. There's something else you should know. Those two men are Lamont Harris and Trey McCall. They were killed by a man named Hollis Dupree.
Yeah, I heard he gunned them down when they showed up to his house asking for help.
Hollis claims it was in self-defense. Said he thought they were there to kill him. Cornelius is the judge that's presiding over the trial.
So killing him might kick up a lot of noise.
Cornelius is an entitled southern asshole. Killing him is gonna do a lot more than kick up some noise. Hopefully, it'll send a message that is long past the time that those cocksuckers went extinct. That's the car down there that Lou was talking about.
That thing armored?
I pulled the work order for it. It's a complete custom job. Tough as hell. It'll take a pounding, but it won't be impossible. Cornelius is scheduled to leave any time now, so this is your window.
You follow a set route?
Not since the trial started, but he still makes a stop or two on the way home. So, you can either hit him then, or go after him when he's driving around.
All right.
I'm looking for Blarney's Pub.
And watch out for the cops.
This nonsense right now. Poor son bitch to pay.
Sorry, Your Honor.
Them Norton papers would have us railroad that man, but I won't have it.
Excuse me for saying, but doesn't the DA want this guy behind bars?
The district attorney agrees with me that a white man should be able to defend his home in this state.
But what are you gonna do, Your Honor?
See justice done. That's what.
Thank you.
everybody out here. Jesus. Compliments of Uncle Lou. Now, what does old Lou have for me today? That's Afghani.
Out of the way.
You gonna love it. Fine, fine. Acting like folks don't have places to be.
Return to patrols. Repeat, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrols.
If you're ready to move against Lou, get in. You want to hear Marcano tear Uncle Lou a new one?
Lou Marcano? Marcano was bribing a district judge named Cornelius Holden. Is that correct?
Sal Marcano spent a lot of money getting Holden in his pocket. A lot of money. Judges like that don't come cheap. And with Holden out of the picture, Sal had to find someone else to legalize gambling.
And that person was State Senator Walter Jacobs.
That's right.
You had one fucking job, Lou. Now it's to keep holding him one goddamn piece to laugh at that room.
What was I supposed to do? He wouldn't listen, Sal. It ain't my fault.
Nothing's ever your goddamn fault. I swear, if you wasn't my brother, I'd clip you myself.
Now listen here. I know a guy, a state senator named Jacobs. He's on the Revenue and Fiscal Affairs Committee. Has a lot of influence.
Can we get to him?
Already have. He has a thing for fucking on women who ain't his wife.
I don't want to twist this guy's balls out of the gate, you understand? We need to be smart about this.
Yeah, of course. How about I throw him a fundraiser on the riverboat? Show him a real nice time. Get him laid. All that shit.
This goddamn casino got me tapped, you understand? This goes down to shitter. We're fucked. All of us.
Well, I'll pick the guests myself. Make sure they know what's what. Then we'll take a nice long cruise down the bayou. Get them all liquored up. Once he sees that payday, Jacobs is gonna do whatever we want.
Lou Marcano knew everyone. I mean, politicians, merchants, lawyers, bankers. He insisted on being called Uncle Lou and was basically the Santa Claus of the French ward.
According to the police reports, Mr. Marcano and Mr. Jacobs were killed during a fundraiser on a riverboat.
The thing about the bayou is it's a very big place. You could blow the living shit out of everything in sight and no one would even notice.
Ready to go when you are.
Assume you already mapped out where the riverboat's gonna go.
Lou's pretty fastidious about that kind of thing. Always follows the same path when he goes cruising through the bayou. Doesn't want anything to happen to his beloved Delphine.
Gonna be the least of his problems. You recon the area?
There's an old coal dumper that they have to sail past. I've already got it rigged to blow. You just need to connect the primer cord to each block and then set it off. Detonator's down by your feet.
All right.
Isolate and kill. Lincoln Clay's specialty. What's wrong? It's the boat thing, isn't it?
Not saying it is, not saying it ain't.
You need to get over it. You were on, what, 40, 45 PBRs in country?
52. That's not the point. You don't know what it's like to get onto a boat knowing full well the damn thing's gonna sink? Gets old, man.
Look. You blow the coal dumper, boom, it hits the boat. Then you jump on board and kill Lou and those other assholes. 50-50, you don't even get wet.
50-50?
40-60, but still.
If you're active duty...
.30-70 at the worst.
Upstairs. You'll fan out. Watch the rest of the boat. This sure shit wasn't an accident.
Run away!
Get him! Kill me!
Please! Please! Gotta move!
I will not have my re-election spoiled by this, Lou.
Thank you. bunker down! Reload! Hey, fellas, that asshole thinks he's tough!
That's far enough, you wop asshole!
What the fuck, Lou?
Take another step and he gets it. You think I give a shit about some politician?
Please! Please, I don't even know what's going on! Kill me.
I don't want your money. I want you to send a message to your brother.
Yeah. Anything. Oh, just say it. Just say it.
Lord Almighty.
Walter Jacobs was killed this evening in a fiery explosion aboard a riverboat. Local businessman Louis Marcano also lost his life, along with dozens of other wealthy donors there to attend a political fundraiser.
When Lincoln left his gutted body on a statue commemorating Andrew Jackson, people were horrified. I mean, how could that be anything but a political statement?
Lagan once told me he couldn't turn any other cheek, that the world doesn't work that way. I spent the better part of 40 years trying to prove him wrong. But I was just lying to myself. Look at how we treat each other. Compassion is a sign of weakness, but greed is a virtue. The poor is considered morally corrupt while every excess of the powerful is celebrated. We sent kids off to die. For what? So someone can make a few bucks? Lincoln was right. He was always right. There ain't never gonna be another Dr. King or a Bobby Kennedy. But there always gonna be another Sal Marcano, another Sammy Robinson, another Lincoln Clay. We are cruel and wicked people.
Fucking King! Nice work out there. The entire goddamn city's buzzing about what we done to Marcano.
There's no one left to stand in our way. We run this city now.
Call me to lock down the whole district, half of it, or none of it at all. I don't give a shit. I handled the last piece of action you put on this table, and I'll handle this one, too.
Makes sense you want to stay one step ahead of us. Not give any obvious tales which way you're leaning. But I will say, it's hard on our boys out there on the street. Not knowing what's actually theirs and what's not.
Too many times I've walked away from this table with nothing, and my boys, they're sitting back home with their thumbs up their arses waiting for a call from you. I'll no longer be ignored. This district comes to me.
Take your time. I'm sitting pretty already.
Don't second guess this, Lincoln.
You got no idea how...
Take your time, lad. Wouldn't want to fuck up this last piece of the city.
I get it. You gotta consider all your options.
Calling this one for Scaletta.
Thanks, kid. Spent most of my life getting fucked by one asshole or another. And what we got going here is a real future. Ain't no one fucking with us anytime soon.
Kinda thought I'd be gay to shit by now. So anything shy of that, and I'm good.
Fuck. Fuck. You know how long I've been waiting for someone to stand up and be a man of his word? And in all my fucking days, you, Lincoln Clay, are the first motherfucker to do it. Thank you.
You've done a hell of a job, Lincoln. Couldn't have done a better job myself. Probably.
I halfway figured Lincoln will have killed us all by now. What we done here, taking the city away from Marcana and doing it without killing each other, we gotta be proud of that. I'll admit it. I had my doubts, but no more. You came through just as you promised, and I'm lucky to be a part of it.
Holy Christ! How the fuck did we make it through this shite in one piece? I thought for certain Scaletta'd have his throat slit by now. It may not have all played out the way I would have liked, but we're here, and we're making money, and Lord knows I'm a hell of a lot better at being alive than I am at being dead.
We're living proof that the ways of Marcano, the lying, the backstabbing, the cheating, don't need to run in that direction. Those ways are as dead as he is.